So here's the answer. So the first one is equivalent. And the reason for that is we have our code here that has if false. False will never be true. So we'll never actually run the break. We'll never reach that code. We'll just run the statement again, and we'll have the same thing that we started with. Every time the test is true, we execute the statement. The second one is not equivalent. And the reason for that is the break will stop the loop. So if the loop would execute more than once, in this version, if we go through the loop twice, in this case, we can only ever go through the statement once, since after we go through the statement once, we reach the break, and then we're done. The third one is not equivalent. So here we're having a while true that will run forever, except for we have the break, so that would stop it. The problem is the test condition for the break is the same as the test condition for the while, but it should really be the opposite. In the while, we keep going as long as the test condition is true. The way I've written the code here, if the test condition is true, we stop. So for this to be equivalent, what we should have written instead would have taken the opposite of the test condition. So if we had if not, which changes true to false and false to true, then the test condition, then the break, this would be equivalent to the original loop. What we have is not. The final one is the most complicated. And this one is actually always equivalent to the original loop. And the reason for that is if we think through the execution, so in the original loop, if the test condition is true, we execute the statement S, and then we keep going. And so if the test condition is true the second time, we execute S again, and we keep going. If we look at what happens here, well, if the test condition is true, we execute S. Then if the test condition is true again, we execute S, and then we keep going. So that has the same behavior. We should trace it through the case where the test condition is not true. So here, if the test condition was true, we execute S. If it's not true the second time, then we're done with the loop and we continue. In this case, if the test condition is true the first time, we'll execute S. If it's not true the second time, then we would go to the else. So if it's not true, we go to the else, then we go to the break, and the break gets out of the loop. So we have the same exact behavior where we executed T once, then we executed S, then we executed T. We didn't execute S again, and we broke out of the loop to continue. So these two are equivalent, the other two are different.